So the bottom line is an ileostomy and a colostomy differ by within. Hi guys, welcome back to another video, and today we'll be looking at stomas. Well, not exactly looking at them, but more talking about stomas and what the differences are between an ileostomy and a colostomy. I'm sure you know the drill. Before we get started, hit that subscribe button. Make sure you give this video a like or even a comment on video ideas you have, and check out all my social media pages where you can find the links to them in the description box below. Right, so I did a video on the different types of surgeries you can have if you have Crohn's or colitis, where I mentioned colostomies and ileostomies. And there have been a few questions as to what differences, so hence why I'm doing this video. So first off, let's discuss what a stoma is. This is basically when a part of your intestine is fed through your abdominal wall, so it's actually poking outside of your body. This bit that is sticking out, that is called the stoma, and the bag which collects what comes out of the stoma is obviously called the stoma bag. Stomas, they can either be temporary or permanent, and each case is different, and each doctor will assess your case differently. And depending on what parts of your intestine is diseased, depends on what will be removed, which will determine if you have a procedure called a colostomy or an ileostomy. And now this is the part where I attempt to explain the differences between the two. So let's start with an ileostomy. This involves the small intestines. So your small intestines are split into three parts. The first part is called the duodenum, which is attached to your stomach. So food passes from your stomach to your duodenum, where the process of digestion occurs, and all your fats, proteins, and carbohydrates are broken down into more easily absorbed parts. So this mixture will pass from your duodenum to the jejunum, which is the second part. And then it moves down to the last portion of your small intestines, which is called the ileum. Okay, so with an ileostomy, it is the last portion of the small intestine which is fed through your abdomen. So your ileum is poking out of your abdominal area, which is forming the stoma. Now, this is usually placed on your lower right-hand side of the abdomen, and any waste products or undigested food that comes out of the small intestines and into the stoma bag will have like a mush-like consistency because it contains a lot of water. And that is because all or most of your water absorption takes place in the large intestines. And obviously, if that mush isn't going through the large intestines, it's going to have still quite a lot of water retention. With me so far? Okay, so a colostomy. Exactly the same principle as an ileostomy, but it's a portion of your large intestine which is being fed through your abdomen. So anything you eat will pass through your small intestines, and whatever is left of your large intestine, depending on how much has been taken out, it will go through that. And the portion of your large intestine will be poking through your abdominal wall to create the stoma. And that's usually located on your lower left-hand side. So the bottom line is an ileostomy and a colostomy differ by with an ileostomy, it is your ileum that's poking out to form the stoma, whereas a colostomy, it is part of your large intestine that is sticking out of your abdomen. And that's pretty much it for this video. I know it was quite short, but that is really the difference between an ileostomy and a colostomy. I do have more information on stoma care over on my Instagram. I don't have a stoma myself, so all the information I do provide has been researched. So if you want to check all that out, follow the links to my social media pages in the description box below. And while you're at it, please hit that subscribe button, and I will see you next week for another video.